Hey, hello everybody, welcome to the Sound Test Room. Today, this evening in the UK, we are taking a look at Aparillo or Aparillo. I'm not really sure how it's pronounced, but it's either or. Hi Stephen, hi Wal, hi Halloween Beats. It's evening here in the UK. Anyway, and anyone else who is watching as well, welcome to you all. Okay, so the cinematic machine synthesizer. Sugar Bytes call it the cinematic machine, and it is exactly that, really. It's basically an FM synth. Hi, Colin. With loads and loads of cool. Options for modulations and things like that. Hi Grant, how are you? So what we're going to do this evening is just play with all the cool sounds. Hi Ian. Just have a listen to the synth. If you haven't already got it, you may think to yourself, this would be awesome. I think I'll get it. There is a link in the description below anyway if you're interested in checking it out. On the App Store. Anyway, right, okay, so I'm going to close the microphone and just pray for a little bit. Hi, Josh. Jamie, Robert, Ian, Pain to Get, Audible Video. Hey, Ed. Thank you. Hi, Bo.
Thank you.
Oh, thanks, Nova. Bless you. Thank you very, 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 very much. It's much appreciated. So it's really easy to actually modulate this stuff inside here. You find a patch that... So you can move it manually. If both of these are switched off, if you open up this here, if the keyboard and the record mode is switched off, nothing is going to happen. So it'll just be dependent on where you place it. These modules here, these are to do with the modules here. sort of thing. So, but to automate it, so if you want to go, you tap the little like, well, you can hit the record for the start off and it'll start to flash. And then as soon as you start to move it around, and then you just open this and hit this button here, and you can stop the record now. Actually, that's weird. Oh, I see. That's odd. Anyway, I don't know, usually works. Thanks, Leon. Top man. Thank you very, very much. I couldn't remember the track I'd used Aparillo on. We have used it. I'm going to be using it now. Or you'd prefer it to be an iPhone as well? No, I get that. A lot of synths now aren't they? Some of the older ones aren't. Funny enough, I noticed that when I was setting up the stream and I was doing the link. And I thought, flipping heck, it's not for iPhone, and like loads of them are now, aren't they? Even the ones that kind of look like they're not. So I can imagine that can be quite annoying. Cheers, Kitch. Master One, what is for iPad and iPhone? Loads and loads of apps are universal, but tons and tons of them. Synth Master One started out as an iPad app and then they updated it. It's still the same synth. Well, it's still Synth Master One. If, do you know what I mean? But I know what you're saying. Yeah, you have to buy it separately for your iPhone. But it's still KV331 Synth Master One. That's what I mean. There are loads and loads of them that do that. The charge for the iPhone version. I think Animoog charges for the iPhone version. I can't remember now. Guys, thank you very, very much for joining me this evening. This evening in the UK, here it's 10 to 9. In the evening, how do you buy the full version? Well, is it one of those, Sugar Bytes tend to do the download it for free, don't they? And then there's an in-app purchase type thing, I guess. So you just hit the in-app and buy it from the App Store, same as all the others. They are lovely, aren't they? Guys, I'll let you say ta-da to each other for a few minutes. Thank you so much for joining me this evening where we took a look at Aparillo or Aparillo, depending on where you're from. And I will see you tomorrow with some more stuff. Yes, yes. Ta-da.